Hi, so this is Riley here, and I am going to basically go through all of my Disney stuff. I don't really have a lot here because I am in the process of moving and I don't have all my Disney stuff here. I have a bunch, but right now I'm just going through what I have here currently, and I'm also going to go through some Bibbidi Bobbidi boxes with you guys. I have already opened them, but I figured I could show you what I got on camera. Then hopefully maybe I'll have enough patience to wait for the next time that I plan to basically do my box. So, I have some information about Bibbidi Bobbidi boxes. And if you just want to get to the boxings or just want to see the Disney stuff, I'll give you a timestamp either here or down below. And you can go to that timestamp and it'll tell you when. I am going to link Bibbidi Bobbidi Boxes in the description, so you can go to their website and check it out. Bibbidi Bobbidi Boxes, these are the ladies. It's Amanda, Brenda, Becky, and Samantha. By the way, I'm not affiliated with them at all. I pay for all this stuff myself. I don't have a code or anything. I just like the company. These women do amazing. So, they do have some non-Disney boxes. They have the Wizard's Vault, which is, they have two tiers. There is Silver, which has three relics, that is $49. And they have the main Wizard's Vault, this is Harry Potter, by the way, in case you didn't know. Then those are four relics for $89. Then there's the Disney boxes. It is Dreams, which has three items for $39. Wishes, which is $49 for 3 to 5 items. Fantasy, which is $59 for 3 to 5 items. Ultimate, which is $119 for 3 to 5 items, but one is a designer item. Either Loungefly, Daniel Cole, Alex and Ani, you name it, you'll get it. So what I really like about this company is that everything's customizable, and the number of items that you get is dependent on if you check whether you're a quantity or quality person. So you might get the same amount depending on your items, or you might get less, but it'll still be the same value. So all of that being said, you can update your preferences. To either, you know, what your favorite characters, your non-favorite characters, what you have, what you're collecting. You got it. You can name it. I will link it below. And that is the end of that. Now, all that being said, let's get to the boxes. So my very first box, I got the July box. And I got, let's see. So I don't have some items because I'm already using them. This is the card that I got with my box. I think everybody gets the same card, but it is the Fab Four. You got Goofy with the camera, Mickey with the, I guess he's just sightseeing like a tourist over there. He has a little Mickey balloon. There's Minnie with a Mickey premium bar, and Donald with the map. Being all, oh, let's go ride this. So this one says, happy summer and happy unboxing. Remember, you're the one who can fill the world with sunshine. So I'm actually going to frame this because I really like it. I think it's really cute. So there's that. That's one cool thing about their cards is you can frame them. This is the spoiler alert sheet. I will pull that out in a minute. So I got a pair of socks. This is a Lion King theme box. I am always, from now on, I'm going to ask for theme boxes just because I think they're a lot more fun because I'm a control person and I like to know a little bit about what I'm going to get. I know I take the fun out of everything. But, so, I got the Lion King socks, which I have already used and worn and everything. Like, one was just like a pattern, and then one was it just said Hakuna Matata on it. All about that life. Because I did say that I liked Lion King and my preferences. Now this is a Wonderground Gallery postcard. isn't that cute? I'm gonna frame it. I'm not gonna send it. I'm one of those people. And they have little stickers. Little pink stickers to show. I thought I saw something. I thought I saw a bug. Excuse me. But they have little pink stickers that say Disney Parks / Resorts exclusive. So that means you can only get this in the parks. So there's that. I got these ears. Aren't they adorable? They have like a little giraffe print on them. And they're so sparkly. Oh, in love. And see, I noticed that a lot of the videos, people are like really like, they go to Disney a lot. A lot. And I don't have that privilege. I've only went one time in my life, and it was when I was 11, and it was for 2 days. So I'm not one of those people. So getting this box is just adding just a little bit of Disney that I need in my life that other people get to witness every day. So I'm enjoying this box a lot. Then, I've already used this, so the sticker is pretty much gone. But it is a Lion King mug. I'm pretty sure this is definitely from the live action, which I'm not crazy about. But the cup is still cute, and it gets the point across, if you know what I mean. But there's Simba and Timon, or Pumbaa, my bad, and Timon, and the sunset, and I'm walking across the bridge. I love it, though. Like, I don't care. I drink out of it anyway. And it just has that on both sides. So, that was it for that box. That box was the $59 one, which, I mean, I was so happy with that, too. I got socks, the cup, the postcard, the ears. And let's see, I gotta have my slip here. It says the Lion King mug was $16. The no-show socks were $14. The Disney Park exclusive Animal Kingdom giraffe print ears were $27.99. The Disney Parks exclusive Wonderground Gallery postcard print Pride Rock was $4.99. And it was, you don't want to see that. It was $64.92. Of course, you won't be able to see it, but it was $64, which that's over what I paid for it. You gotta give it that. All right, so that was box one. That was the $59 box. Now, for my second box, I got the big one. I got the Ultimate Magic Box, the $119 box that's supposed to include the designer item. Okay, let's just jump. So I got a Judy Hopps plush. Is she not the cutest? Look at her purple eyes and her little police outfit and her ears and her back. Look at her little tail. It's so fluffy. So that is my Judy. And I also got the Nick Wilde plush. I told them that I liked plushes, and I told them that I liked Zootopia. Perfect. There's his eyes and his nose. His little outfit is giving me life right now. Like, look at his little, perfect. And his little feetsies. And his big, big fluffy tail. So cute. But I have to, like, I get them together. They're so cute. I love them. But I got a set. I'm so excited. All right. Oh, I didn't go over the sheets and the cards. Oh, that's upsetting. Anyway, so this is this box's card. So it is Bibbidi Bobbidi Box's 1 year birthday, which is great. And it says, Happy birthday, BBB, 1 year. From the bottom of our hearts, we want to thank each of you for making this dream of ours a reality. We are so grateful that you have allowed us the opportunity to share our passion with you. We hope through the process we have made each of your days a little more, or a little extra magical. And they certainly have. I've Like I said, I've never went to the park, so this is just like having my own little park come to me. And it says, all of your dreams can come true if we have the courage to pursue them. Mr. Walt Disney himself. I'm actually going to cut the quote off and hang it up. Am I weird? I don't know. And so here's the spoiler again. I'll show you that in a minute. But there was a little extra magic this time because of the birthday. There's this little envelope with a pink sticker. And no, I don't have the patience to not look at it. Squeeze me. So, first we have a pen. We have the Happy Birthday BBB pen. And we have little stickers on there from the box. I've even showed you the box. I'm terrible. But, oh well. So I'm going to go least a favorite. So the first one I got is a Dole Whip. Is that not cute? Just the sticker itself. Love the extra magic. This is the Up House. And I love Up. It's one of my favorite Pixar movies. Number one being Toy Story. Don't judge me for being, you know, don't judge me for liking a mainstream thing. And I got the castle. I've been watching everybody's Bibbidi Bobbidi Boxings and I'm like, I hope I get the castle sticker. And I did. I'm so excited. Yes. Yes. I'm so happy I got the castle. It like made my day when I saw that I got that. I was like, yes. My box. I'm like, I got the castle sticker. Alright, now let's see. I'm gonna look for the one item. Okay, so I got one item that I'm gonna show like for the finale of the boxes. But this was in the bag when I got it. I wasn't even looking in the bag. And then usually they keep the stuffing in the bag. And it wasn't in there. And I was like, wait. So I looked at it and it's a little mini Thumper Jim Shore. Is he not the cutest? Look at his little tooth. Like, and Thumper is one of my favorite characters ever. So I'm so excited. And he's my very first Jim Shore item. I am going to keep him out. I am an out-of-box collector, as I have learned. I don't like to keep things in the boxes. I'm sorry. I know I'm a horrible person. But he's just too cute not to keep out and show off those colors. So, I learned that I love Jim Shore's and I have specifically changed my preferences. And I asked for a theme box for one thing. For two, I asked for more Jim Shore because I want to expand my collection and have more Jim Shore in my life. Buy some too. Who knows? Well, we're just gonna go with it. Alright, so this is the main finale of the box. This is the Belle Limited Edition Loungefly. Isn't it fabulously gorgeous? So you've got, let's see, you've got Belle on there, you've got Mrs. Potts and Chip, you've got her with the Enchanted Rose, you got the Bee on there, you've got, let's see, you've got Lumiere down here, chilling, and the gorgeous pink right here, oh my gosh, and you've got this gorgeous gold that goes on the pink, and the Loungefly, and now, don't judge me, but I got some stuff in here. I've already been using it, but there is the, it's just like, it's gorgeous. I'm really happy because this is also my very first Loungefly mini backpack. Surprise, surprise. Okay, so that was the end of the boxes. So, like I said, my Disney collection is not very big right now. Do not judge me. I have a lot of my stuff at home. A lot of it. I have a lot at home. I also have all of my Disney VHS tapes. Ask your parents if you want to know what that is. This is the box. I think it's gorgeous. So we are going to move on to the stuff I already own. Which is not very big. I have like 3 items. That's it. 3. I'm building it up and it's not that much. But it's okay. We don't judge here. But I will say, I have a lot of Christmas Disney items. I like Mickey themed Christmas stuff. So I will be doing a Christmas holiday Disney collection when it comes time, which is November. Don't be mad at me. I like to celebrate early. So, my very first item that I'm going to pull out is my stuffed animal, Simba. Is he not the cutest? I actually sleep with him. Okay, but this was given to me on Valentine's Day a few years ago because Lion King is still and will always be, if not my favorite Disney movie, but my favorite movie of all time, period. And don't even mention the live action, okay? It was a disgrace. Don't. I know people liked it. I'm sorry. But don't remake perfection. I'm just going to say that. Don't remake perfection. Okay. So, basically the story is, my fiance got me this when, a couple years ago, because I told him that I had a stuffed animal Simba when I was little, and I would like to have one again for my children to pass along. But I gave mine away when I was a kid to my cousin. And so, he got me one for Valentine's Day, and it's one of the best things ever. I cried. So yeah, so this is my second item is this. Is this? It's Hallmark. Yeah, this Hallmark Cinderella and Prince Charming wedding. I think it's supposed to be an ornament, I think. But I use it just sitting out because it means so much to me already. So I got engaged on Christmas of last year. I'll link that video down below. But I got engaged and my grandma got us this for our engagement. Is that not the most gorgeous thing? Like, it has some like rose gold in it and the love, and that's not the best part. There's a little button. Don't want to get copyrighted, people, but it literally plays the entire song. But yeah, that was my little, I'm thinking of actually using it for our cake topper. Comment if you think that's a good idea. I'm scared of ruining it, but I think that would be so cool and so just nice for my grandma to know that I used it in that way. But there's the back of it. I just think it's such a good gift. Like, I'm really happy with it, and I actually set it just out on a table because it means so much to me. It was our centerpiece for our actual dining table for a while. And the very last item that I have, gotta be careful with this one because this one's actually gonna get used. So, a little background. I just told you that I got engaged, and I know it's weird that I'm having a theme wedding and I want to use that, but anyway, I'll get to it. So, it's the enchanted rose. So, I'm having a Beauty and the Beast themed wedding. And I'm trying not to have it in your face, Disney. Like, just like some happily ever afters and like the music and some, I don't know, like maybe like a regular teapot on the table, you know, subtle Disney. And I'm not gonna be in a yellow dress or nothing crazy like that. That ain't happening. But I thought these would be perfect for the centerpieces on our wedding table. And I love the fact that you can... Well, I think that the batteries are dead, but I will insert a video of what it looks like lit up for you.
Tell as old as time, true as it can be.
Just a little change, small to say the least. Both a little scared, neither one prepared. Beauty and the Beast.
Okay, so I think that's about it, guys. I don't think there's anything else. So I'm gonna try and make more videos coming up. So, if you enjoy, like, comment, you know, put my Instagram and everything else below, you know the drill. So, you guys have a great day. I love y'all.